Hey, it's Peter. I'm really excited to share with you our new operational marketing funnel builder from Plannuh. What is an operational marketing funnel builder? Well, it's a tool that allows you as a marketer to model out a best practices conversion funnel that helps you determine what targets you need to set and what outcomes you might get for achieving those targets along the way. So let me explain. What the tool allows you to do is model out your funnel. So I'm going to start with this little wizard here. Once I log in, it says, what's your target? And I can pick lots of different targets. I can say it's inquiries, opportunities, whatever it is. Let's start with revenue because that's one that everybody can understand. So I'm going to say I need to generate $5 million of revenue. So it enters in the data in my funnel here. And now I'm going to go to my conversion rates. Now, as I look at this, this is sort of a standard funnel that says leads, opportunities, and deals, but maybe that's not the standard model I use in my company. So let's change the terminology to say that, well, we really start with inquiries on our side, and next we go to MQLs is our next step, and we have a sales acceptance step, so we're going to call it sales accepted leads, opportunities, and we call our deals, let's say we call this closed one. So now I've got a funnel that's built in my terminology, and it's got my target of revenue. Now, what the wizard is going to ask me is, what are my conversion rates? So I can either type them in here, or I can sort of edit right in here, but let's use the wizard and say that my inquiry to MQL conversion, let's say that's about 2.5%. Great. So next, I'm going to go to my next conversion rate, my MQL to sales accepted lead. Let's say we're pretty industry standard and it's about 67%, about 2/3 of the time. Marketing says it's a lead. Sales says, yeah, that is indeed a lead. Now let's look at our sales accepted lead. How often are they converted into an opportunity in the pipeline? Let's say that that's about 20%. And then finally, what percentage of opportunities that enter our pipeline end up being won? And let's say we're pretty good at it. We're going to say it's about 35%. You can see the magic starting to happen here. It's now calculated my pipeline value. How much pipeline do I need to achieve that $5 million revenue target? So next, let's go to the next step in the wizard and say, well, what's our average deal size? And this is going to help us calculate all the rest of the targets in my funnel. So if I say my average deal size is $25,000, as an example, it's going to go in and it's going to calculate all of these steps along the way. So now I need, I need 170,000 inquiries to get a little more than 4,000 MQLs, a little less than 3,000 sales accepted leads to get a little less than 600 opportunities, and 200 of them are going to end up being closed. And 25,000 times 200, as you probably figured out, is my $5 million target. So that's a quick view of the funnel. Now I can go and edit any of these things if I don't believe that these are the right numbers, and it's going to help me have a little bit extra detail. Now here's an extra trick you can do. I might want to add an after revenue metric. So let's say that I've got a step at the bottom here that I'm going to call lifetime value or LTV. Now, what I want to do here is say, what's my conversion rate? What's my conversion rate from a closed customer? If I've got a ARR business, how long do they stay? And let's say they stay for about 4 years. That means that it's about a 400% conversion rate. So that means that $5 million of annualized revenue turns into a $20 million lifetime value. So this is the way to really customize your funnel for your specific business. Okay, so now I've got all my conversion rates. They're all set. And let's take one more step and say, I've defined my funnel. Now what I can go in and do is say, I can, based on the cost of some of these metrics, if I know that data, I can come up with a budget recommendation. So it's going to allow me to pick any of these. So maybe I know the cost for one deals or opportunities or MQLs. Let's pick MQLs and say that I know that an MQL historically has cost me about $250 to generate, which means that it's going to cost about $1 million of demand generation budget to generate that $5 million in revenue. And then lastly, I can actually download slides, and these slides are going to be customized to my funnel. And what they're going to show me is all of the data that I have nicely summarized. So here's a little slide deck. It's going to show me what my funnel is with all these steps and these assumptions along the way. It's going to say, this is what the budget is required for me to hit my $5 million revenue target. And then finally, there's a little info about the more advanced funnel that we have in the full version of Plannuh that allows you to calculate revenue per outcome and profitability and have multiple funnels and cool stuff like that. And you can schedule a demo with us to see a more detailed one. So that's the Funnel Builder. I'm super excited about it. I hope you enjoyed it too. And thanks for watching.